Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. This is definitely my fourth or fifth time trying to record this intro. I'm trying to get it right. I need to just chill. Today we are going to be talking about binge eating. This is a topic that hits really close to home for me. I've been dealing with binge eating for just way too long, and I don't want to say that it's just like gone completely and I don't have any more binges, but I know that they have decreased significantly. So I just want to offer you, you know, a little insight into maybe something that you're struggling with, and maybe we can hash it out and, you know, get to the bottom of it and maybe reduce your binges too. So we're going to talk about what is a binge, have you been depriving yourself, and how you can stop. So what is a binge, right? A binge probably looks different on everyone, and the reasons are probably different for everyone. But I know for me, I definitely am seeking comfort in the food. I definitely feel powerless to the food. Like if I'm eating, I just can't stop. I just can't stop whatever it is that I'm consuming. Also, another thing is like, I have to eat it to completion. I can't just like let there be leftovers. Like there was just the time where there's going to be no leftovers. And if there was leftovers, they weren't lasting very long. I know a lot of my binges circle around my boredom, and a lot of my binges are through emotional eating. So how do you know when you're binge eating? And there's a few indicators, right? For one, you're just eating a large amount of food. Another way to determine if you're, you know, struggling with binge eating is when you feel embarrassed or you try and hide food, you try and eat alone so that nobody can see you eating. You feel really guilty after finishing your binge or after eating at all, really. It is just kind of something you can't stop. You can't help. It just is just like happening, and you just kind of have to get to the root of the problem. And ultimately, that's what we're here to do, hopefully. I love eating and watching TV and watching shows, watching movies, stuff like that. I love snacking and watching shows. So sometimes when I do that, it'll just get way too out of hand, or like just whatever I'm eating just tastes so good. Like I just have to keep eating it. I just can't put it down. So I just know that it was an issue when I just would wake up the next day from eating extremely late, or finishing that snack or finishing that binge, and just, it's just a feeling I can't describe, you know? It's just like, damn. Like the guilt is just there, it's present, and it doesn't go away. It's just like, dang, why'd you do that? Or even while you're doing it, it's just like, are you really just gonna keep doing this? Like, you can stop eating. I literally tell myself to stop eating, and I can't stop eating. So it's just a whole problem in itself. So next, how you can distinguish if you have been depriving yourself. Now, if you have some late night stomach rumblings, you feel like you can't get your mind off of food, then you definitely know that you've been depriving yourself. But if you are a severe binge eater, if you're a severe binge eater, as I was, then you know that no matter what you do, you can't get your mind off of the food. Like, it just can't be helped. Like, even if you're on a diet, you can't stop thinking about the next meal. You can't stop thinking about what you're gonna have next. Like, if you can have that meal, if that is a good idea to eat that thing, you know what I mean? Like, so in the beginning, it's going to be torture. In the beginning, it is going to be, what is the word I'm trying to say? It's like coming off an addiction. No, because it is an addiction. Okay, yes, no, it is an addiction. And you are having withdrawals. You're going through the withdrawal process because you've been addicted to food, and it's just, you're trying to tackle the issue now and you're having withdrawals. Like, that's just kind of what it feels like. So the first week or the first 2 weeks, it's gonna differ person to person. I know it definitely took me about a week and a half before I started to feel a little more normal. Another way you can determine if you've been depriving yourself is if you are currently dieting. And are you dieting heavy? Are you trying to reach a goal really fast and you've just been overdoing it and you've been depriving yourself of food? You've been having too little calories. I really know that a lot of these, like, one only eat 1,000 calories, only eat 1,200 calories and stuff like that. These kind of diets, like, I do not recommend these kinds of diets because I feel like they breed binge eating disorder. I feel like it breeds body dysmorphia when you eat too little calories. So I just want to say that I feel like a minimum, even if you are like 5'2" and you're trying to lose weight, I know that when you're shorter, it's more difficult to lose weight. It's just how it is. And you just have to put a little more work in. Men, they have it a little easier than us. They just naturally do. So we do have to put a little more work in, and just keep that in mind, and just know that you're doing it for yourself and that you're just trying to get better, and it's gonna be worth it. So just keep that in mind. If you are dieting, keep in mind that you do need to be giving yourself sufficient calories. You need to be eating enough, minimum 1500 calories a day, I feel like, or 1400 if you really wanna, like if you want more of a deficit. But 1500 calories, I feel like, are minimum for a day. I don't think you should be going less than that. I think it's dangerous. All right, so let's talk about some ways that we can stop binge eating, or some ways that have helped me stop binge eating. One of the ways that I was able to kind of reduce my binges is if I think about how I felt. I am a person that kind of just like forgets about the emotion, or like I can't hold grudges. That's just not like not who I am, because I will forget about how I felt in that moment, exactly how I felt in that moment. So I did struggle a little bit with that, but after so many times of repeating to myself, just remember how you felt after you've completed that binge, especially late night binges, which are the worst in the morning when you wake up with acid. I had a lot of traumatic experiences with binging, so it was a lot easier for me to remember and recall how shitty it felt, basically. Another way to reduce your binges or stop depriving yourself is to volume eat and to replace those snacks that are probably just that one snack that you probably have that's just like really bad for you, but you need it so much. And I know a lot of that is Hot Cheetos for a lot of you. Hot Cheetos really gets to a lot of people, I've noticed. Try and just, make these simple swaps, or try and make something else your favorite snack for the time being, just until you can kind of regulate yourself. For example, I just need to eat a lot. I need to eat plentiful, not minimal, So I need to have snacks that are pretty much lower in calories so that I can consume a lot of them. I don't know, just so I can fulfill that mental game is real, guys. Like I need to, if I see on that plate that there's not enough food, I'm bothered. Like I need to see that there is enough food there, even if my eyes are bigger than my stomach. I just do. Also, when you start to swap some of your snacks for more healthier snacks, things that are doing a little more for your body, then you stay full longer and you're able to reduce those binges, because you literally cannot put more food inside. The first couple days are just really going to be awful. So just keep in mind that it is just like this mental game, and you're just, everything that's happening is in your head. So when you're thinking about the food or you're thinking about the next meal, it's just all mental. You just have to channel your energy into something else, or you just have to just, something that I did was just keep telling myself, just like, all right, tomorrow, if I go to bed, like tomorrow's a new day. Tomorrow's a new day, and I made it a whole other day. And that was also another way I was able to make it through a lot of these diets that I was doing. I was just like, you know what? It's just, tomorrow's a whole other day. I just have to get to sleep, and boom, this day was done. It's just kind of like checking off the boxes, checking off the days, because one day at a time, just one day at a time. So I hope that you got a little something out of this video. I hope that you learned maybe a little something about yourself, maybe a trick or two to help with your binges. But ultimately, I do want to have a conversation about it. So go ahead, leave your comments down below. If you do struggle with, binge eating, or you have some tips, leave them there. So if you did like this video, please like it so that it can reach others. And hopefully I see you in my next upload. Bye.